Imagine a world where we could directly edit an individual's DNA and prevent hereditary diseases. This may seem like something straight out of a movie, but I'm about to tell you something that will shock you. It's happening today, in real life. And it's all thanks to CRISPR-Cas9. So you might be wondering, what is CRISPR-Cas9? What does it do exactly? Well first, let's talk about something we all try to avoid, viruses. When bacteria gets infected with viruses, they capture some of their DNA in a certain pattern known as CRISPR arrays. These RNA arrays act as memory for the bacteria, allowing them to remember the virus and act as an alarm for the next invasion. If they get attacked, they can use the Cas9 enzyme to break apart the DNA of the virus and stop the attack. Researchers have taken some notes from this process and have used it to edit DNA for what is now known as CRISPR-Cas9. They create a small piece of RNA that binds to a specific target sequence in the DNA of a cell, similar to the RNA segment from the CRISPR arrays that attach to the virus's DNA. When introduced into cells, the guide RNA recognizes the intended DNA sequence, and typically, the Cas9 enzyme cuts the DNA at the targeted location, just like in the case of the bacteria. Once the DNA is cut, researchers use the cell's own DNA repair machinery to add or delete pieces of genetic material, or to make changes to a DNA by replacing an existing segment with a customized DNA sequence. CRISPR clearly has a ton of potential, and a lot of it lies in treating and curing diseases such as sickle cell disease. But before that, what is sickle cell disease? Sickle cell disease, or SCD, is a group of genetic red blood cell disorders, and the most common subtype of SCD is sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell disease affects hemoglobin, which are the oxygen-carrying protein in red blood cells, and causes the red blood cells of an affected individual to become crescent or sickle-shaped, as well as more stiff and sticky. And as such, sickle cell disease affects the ability of red blood cells to carry oxygen, and these sickle-shaped cells tend to stick together and block blood vessels. Sickle cell disease is an inherited disease, and individuals with sickle cell disease inherit two abnormal hemoglobin genes from their parents. These abnormal hemoglobin genes are predominantly caused by a single point mutation in a specific gene for a subunit of the hemoglobin protein. But you may be wondering, what is a point mutation? Well, to put simply, a point mutation is where a single building block of DNA, known as a base pair, is changed, inserted, or deleted from the DNA sequence that make up the gene. So what are the major symptoms of sickle cell disease? Well, here's a scenario. A 5-year-old girl was rushed to the hospital because she started exhibiting the following symptoms. Sudden mild pain in her arm and joints, known as pain crisis, and swelling of the toes, also called dactylitis. Increasing tiredness and fatigue, which started occurring 2 days prior, and her skin is also turning slightly yellow, indicating jaundice. The physician conducted a blood test and found low levels of red blood cells, and based on this and the symptoms presented, the patient was diagnosed with sickle cell anemia. Aside from this, other major life-threatening symptoms include acute chest syndrome, which occurs when sickle-shaped red blood cells block the blood flow in the blood vessels of the lungs, stroke, and also splenic sequestration, which is where sickle-shaped red blood cells become stuck in the spleen. Finally, most common treatment options for sickle cell disease generally have the goals of prevention and management of symptoms and complications. For example, voxelotor prevents red blood cells from forming into the sickle shape and sticking to one another, improving blood flow. And hydroxyurea helps to reduce the number of episodes of pain crises and acute chest syndrome. Currently, blood and bone marrow transplant is the only curative treatment for sickle cell disease, but novel research into the use of CRISPR-Cas9 has shown promising results. You might be asking yourself, has CRISPR ever been used directly on a patient with sickle cell disease? Well, it has. The case of Victoria Gray serves as a notable example, as she is the first sickle cell disease patient to be treated with CRISPR. It was in 2019 when Gray found herself grappling with the overwhelming burden of this condition, enduring the unpredictable and debilitating pain episodes that would require persistent blood transfusions and medications. It was this relentless struggle that led her to consider CRISPR. 4 years later, Gray does not display any sickle cell disease symptoms, and is living a life of what she describes without limitations, and as a person who has been reborn. So how does CRISPR work in treating sickle cell disease, as seen in Victoria Gray's case? One method that is currently in phase 2 of clinical trials involves altering the gene expression of the protein called gamma globin. Briefly, the fetal hemoglobin contains 2 alpha and 2 gamma chains. Around birth, there is an increase in expression of the suppressor gene called BCL11A. This gene will decrease the expression of the gamma globin protein. The gamma globin component of the hemoglobin will then be replaced by beta globin, and the composition of the adult hemoglobin will now contain two alpha and two beta globin chains. In sickle cell disease, there is a mutation on the gene that codes for the beta globin protein that results in the abnormal hemoglobin structure. Research has consistently shown that removing the suppression by the BCL11A gene on the fetal gamma globin gene can dampen the symptoms of sickle cell disease, as it would compensate for the lost beta globin chains caused by that mutation. So, what exactly are researchers doing to induce this? Well, in the first step, cells called hematopoietic stem and progenitor cells will be isolated from the patient's bone marrow. A Cas9 system will also need to be isolated from the bacteria Streptococcus pyogenes. To help facilitate its delivery and precise editing in the cells, the Cas9 system and a guide RNA, also called gRNA, will be delivered as a protein complex called precomplex ribonucleoprotein. The ribonucleoprotein carrying the Cas9 system will then be infused into the donor cells through electroporation, a method in which the membrane permeability is increased using short high voltages. In step 3, once inside the cells, gRNA will guide Cas9 endonuclease, which is an enzyme that breaks the bond holding the DNA together, to the suppressing gamma globin gene BCL11A. Cas9 endonuclease will cut the gene, which induces a repair pathway called non-homologous end joining. Basically, this pathway will repair the cut by adding or removing nucleotides, which can in turn disrupt the BCL11A gene's function. As a result, this will remove the suppression of the gamma globin gene. Lastly, the gene-edited cells are then infused back into the patient, which will later differentiate into mature blood cells that contain the fully functional fetal hemoglobin. So you must be wondering what the advantages are to using CRISPR for treating sickle cell disease. Well, using CRISPR allows the patient to be treated in one treatment rather than using a lifetime of transfusions and medications for sickle cell disease. Another advantage is that it eliminates the need to find a human leukocyte antigen donor for a blood or bone marrow transfusion. Finally, the last advantage is that it eliminates the risk of graft versus host disease. This occurs when bone marrow or stem cells are transplanted into a recipient from the donor, and the recipient's body classifies the cells as foreign material, which leads to an allergic reaction in which the cells start attacking the human body. Now, what are the disadvantages? Well, one of the main disadvantages of using CRISPR to treat sickle cell disease is that because CRISPR involves gene editing, this could introduce a genetic mutation in off-target regions of the DNA, which could lead to greater adverse effects compared to the benefits of this treatment. Another disadvantage is that the use of this technique for treating sickle cell disease is relatively new, with the first successful treatment occurring in 2021, and therefore, it is currently not FDA approved. Finally, the last disadvantage is that since CRISPR is a relatively new technique for clinical applications, not all labs have gene editing technology, and therefore, optimizing the CRISPR protocol to maintain a high editing efficiency can be time-consuming and challenging. So, as we learned today, CRISPR is a novel technology that is currently being tested and used for its ability to cure sickle cell disease.